Dear sisters, associates of wisdom, honored guests, and friends, what a glorious moment this is, a moment of coming together to celebrate the evolving story of our 7 decades as the United States province of the Daughters of Wisdom. It has been a breathtaking journey, this business of revealing divine wisdom at the heart of our world. We who have walked the path of wisdom these 70 years have met so many of you along the way, so many of you who are gathered here this afternoon, who have been invited with us into this relationship with God. In the Old Testament book of wisdom, 7:27, we read, "In every generation, wisdom passes into holy souls and makes them friends of God." So welcome, all you holy souls and friends of God. Our founder, St. Louis Marie de Montfort, in his 18th century work, Love of Eternal Wisdom, writes, "If it is music you desire, desire wisdom, who is the source of all that music." It is an honor of this deep connection between wisdom and the power of music itself that we welcome Schola Sine Nomine to celebrate here with us at St. Martin of Tours. The members of this Schola trace their ethnic roots from Korea, Hong Kong, Philippines, and Japan, in Asia to Great Britain, Italy, Germany, Czechoslovakia, and Lithuania in Europe. Through their performance this afternoon, we are united to the entire global community. Welcome, Schola Sine Nomine.
Good afternoon. It is my privilege to be your host as we unfold our program of celebration and music. And as your host, I will offer a brief reflection at the start of each musical piece. So sit back and enjoy it all. We open our program this afternoon with a song of praise and thanksgiving for the beauty of the earth. Though created by a Methodist hymn writer, there is a deep connection with the beliefs of our founder, St. Louis de Montfort, who was a mystic, who attributes earth's beauty to the Creator. For Montfort, this Creator is the one whom we call wisdom, dwelling within creation to contain, sustain, and maintain us, and who is the order and harmony of the universe. So let's listen to this hymn, inviting us to be God's partner in repairing the world with justice. With earth, our holy ground, we are empowered to live more justly and more fully in love with God and one another, and to step lightly upon this beautiful green planet.
Thank you.
The world continually participates in God, and God in the world. So next, as we listen to this hymn titled, God Be in My Head, we are reminded that the human person is created to see God in every aspect of life, life charged with divine energy. Though the text of the hymn dates back to the pre-Reformation period in England, the music is by a present-day composer from New England, Eric Helmuth. The music, though quite solemn in tone, imparts an urgent plea, a deep desire to experience the presence of God. In its rendition, the scola captures a human longing that God might dwell in head and heart and understanding for as long as life will last. We daughters of wisdom often hear ourselves exclaiming that wisdom dwells in experience. Yes, experience, all of it, lying in the details of our lives, God in the details of all growth and making. As we prepare to listen to the beloved air of Gounod's Ave Maria with words that are so familiar to us, we invite you to reflect on this power of the Spirit through which Mary encountered the mystery of the living God, the gracious God of her life, the saving wisdom of her people. This prayer is very special to all daughters of wisdom, for Mary testifies to hearing the word of God and keeping it, doing it and acting upon it. The history of our 70 years as the U.S. province has brought us to a different kind of listening and to a new kind of action. The responses needed today are not found in the big initiatives of the past, but instead are like tiny mustard seeds, a word of hope, a listening heart, a compassionate presence, a healing glance. It is with great joy this afternoon that we welcome our soloist, Nicole Entrevia, to perform Ave Maria.
Thank you.
Composer of the Renaissance era, Thomas Tallis illumines the familiar words of Jesus, "If you love me." Such are the words spoken by Jesus' incarnate wisdom, making us an offer we simply can't refuse. If we love him, incarnate wisdom will send us a comforter, another term for spirit with us. We daughters of wisdom, in our seventh decade, here and now, we know that the Spirit is with us as we give ourselves to an emerging future, allowing our choices to resonate across a holy future, across every living entity of our wisdom congregation.
Thank you.
We return to another offering of Ave Maria, this time by the Austrian composer Anton Bibel, creator of this rich blending of a seven-part chorus. We pause to recall a favorite line again from St. Louis de Montfort's treatise on true devotion to Mary, in which he writes, "Of Mary, there is never enough." The world of music would agree, for hundreds of Ave Marias have been written and scores of choral arrangements have been created, celebrating Mary's conscious and active faith, a faith based on a bedrock conviction that God is faithful. Let us listen to the deep and luxurious voices of the Schola, giving praise to Mary, model of all discipleship.
Thank you.
Leonard Cohen, author of this now famous piece, Hallelujah, refers to his own composition as, quote, a blaze of light in every word. He tells us that the use of the Hallelujah comes from being open and transparent before God, though we are broken human beings, all of us, so stop pretending. Like David, hero, king, and songwriter, we will be hurt, tested, challenged. Love will break our hearts. Music will offer solace. We will be faced with joy and with pain, but not surrender to despair or nihilism. Hallelujah is the songwriter's offering of hope and perseverance in the face of a cruel world. Holy and broken, there is still the Hallelujah. To perform it, we welcome back Nicole Entrevia.
Thank you.
For our next selection, the scholar will sing in French, Notre Père, to honor the country of our founders, St. Louis Marie de Montfort and Blessed Marie-Louise Trichet, and to commemorate the birthplace of our congregation. As we listen to this prayer of Jesus, sung in French, we experience a softer, gentler version than often escapes our lips in the English version, as we seek not to trespass or be trespassed against or led into temptation. This French version we are about to hear has a Celtic quality about it. Pardon our falseness, as we forgive those who are untrue to us. Do not forsake us in our need, but lead us to new birth, for the glory of life and the light of life are yours forever. As we wind our way down today's program, we are invited to listen to a warm blending of voices singing, "You Are the New Day." The tone seems to fit the words we hear, quote, "Love of life will urge me to say, you are the new day." Yet, we are intrigued over who might be the you of the new day. Is it about a loving couple who gaze upon their newborn child? Or again, could it be about a group of scientists who have dedicated their lives to finding a way to reverse the terrible effects of climate change? Or is it really about hope? Hope itself, believing in an unknown and an unknowable future. We could go on, couldn't we? So let's go back to the very beginning when Sister Kathy spoke this morning in the introduction about wisdom making us friends of God. Divine wisdom delights in creation and in her children. From her we learn a new relatedness, a new way of being in the world. Instead of standing in the world looking for God, one stands in God and looks out at the world. Walking with wisdom, we participate in the new future that is breaking into our midst through the power of love. And we pray, O wisdom, irrepressible goodness of creation, you are the new day. As we conclude our program this afternoon, the Schola will send us forth with a blessing. So let this day be a day of blessing when we gather up all those who have blessed us with their lives, all daughters of wisdom, associates, family, and friends who have gone before us. Let this be a time to offer blessings upon each one of you gathered here. May you go with the protection of God, who made you for wholeness, the encompassing of Christ, who calls you beloved, the grace of the Spirit, who bids us be as one.